Now let us solve this problem. Design DFA which accepts set of all strings containing 1100 as a substring. Okay, over the alphabet sigma is equal to 0, 1. So here the DFA should accept 1100 as the substring. So before 1100 we can have any number of zeros and ones. After 1100 we can have any number of zeros and ones. We should not bother about that, but the corresponding string should contain 1100 as a substring. Okay, so here 1100 totally contains 4 characters. So if there are 4 characters, then we require 4 plus 1, that is 5 states. So let us construct DFA with the 5 states. Here the starting state, let the starting state is Q0. Next we have Q1. Next we have Q2. Next we have Q3. Next Q4 is the final state. So here what is the substring? 1100 is the substring here. Okay, so if we apply 1 on Q0, then we will go to Q1. 1 on Q1 means Q2, 0 on Q2 means Q3, 0 on Q3 means Q4. So Q4 is the final state. Now let us check whether this is correct DFA or not. This is not correct DFA. Why? Because DFA means each state must uses all the symbols which are present in the alphabet, but on Q0 only 1 is used. So we have to apply 0 on Q0. On Q1 also 1 is used. So we have to apply 0 on Q1. Okay, so likewise we have to apply the remaining symbols on the corresponding states also. So on Q0 we need to apply which symbol? Already 1 is applied, so we have to apply 0 on Q0. Here 1100 is the substring here. Before 1100 we can have any number of zeros here, so we should not bother about that. Okay, so here we can take the self loop 0. Okay, so Q0 is over. Why? Because on Q0 0 is applied, 1 is applied. Next on Q1 we have to apply 0 here, but here if you take self loop 0 here, then what will happen? The string will become 1010. The substring will become 1010. If you take a self loop like this, then the substring will become 1010. But here the substring is 1100. So we have to backtrack to its previous state. So whenever we apply 1 on Q1, then backtrack to its previous state. Why? Because after 0, we can have 1100. Let us assume that we have a string like this. 010, 1100. So 0. So if we apply 0 on Q0, we will be at Q0 only. If we apply 1 on Q0, then we will go to the Q1. If we apply 0 on Q1, then we will go to the Q0. Next 1100 means we will get the final state. Okay, so after 0 we can have 1100 as a substring. Now let us focus on Q2 state. On Q2 we applied only 0. So now we have to apply 1 on Q2. So can we take a self loop like this? Yeah, we can take like this. Why? Because here this is nothing but 1100. So 1100 is nothing but the substring here. If you take a string like this, 0 1 1 0 1 1 1 0 0. Okay, so 0 means we will be at Q0 only. So 1 means we will move to the Q1. So 1 means we will move to the Q2. Next to 0 0. Okay, so here we have 1100 as a substring here. Okay, next can we apply 1 on Q3 a self loop like this? We can't apply like that. Why? Because if we apply like that, then we will get so here 1100, we will get 100. So 100 as the substring. Okay, but here we don't have 100. So whenever we have to apply where we have to apply 1 on Q3, we have to backtrack to its previous states here. Here it is better to backtrack to either Q1 or Q0. So to which state we have to perform the backtracking? Okay, we can backtrack to Q1, there is no problem. So if we apply 1 on Q3, then go to the Q1. Why? Because after this one, we may have 1100. After this one, we may have 1100 as a substring. Okay, Then after that, here after 1100, we can have any number of zeros and ones. There is no restriction on that. So we can have any number of zeros and ones after that. So this is the DFA for this problem.